Welcome to Wrocław in Poland. It's game day 7 of the Basketball Champions League. It's a Wednesday evening here, and it's Anvil Wrocław versus AIK, the 2017-2018 champions. Very warm welcome as the Basketball Champions League gets back underway. And it's two teams that are having a good start to the season. Anvil Wrocław 3-3 and AIK 4-2. Here's the games so far. We've got Jerusalem versus Antwerp as well today. And Rasta Vector have already played San Pablo Burgos yesterday. San Pablo Burgos winning that one. So this is a massive game between two teams that are doing well domestically, have great history in their own domestic leagues. And the teams contain first and second leading point scorers. I'll come back to that shortly. Here's the Group B standings. San Pablo Burgos leading after their seven games with 11 points. AIK in fourth. And Anvil Wrocław in sixth. Top four from each of the four regular season groups of eight teams will qualify for the round of 16 knockout. We've got Keith Langford at 22.2 points a game, leads the Basketball Champions League in scoring. Tony Roten, 19.8 points a game. And Howard St. Ruse is third in efficiency. And let's look at the AIK roster. Players to look out for: Kendrick Ray, Keith Langford, Jonas Maciulis, Nikos Gikas, Howard St. Ruse, Stefan Jankovic just joined the team recently, and Marcus Slaughter is the leading rebounder for AIK. Langford's leading in points, obviously, and Howard St. Ruse leads AIK in assists as well. This is the best season so far for assists. He's having a great all-round season. Anvil Wrocław, you've got Chris Day, you've got Ricky Lido, Chase Simon, but Tony Roten, third in all-round scoring. He has the most points at the hoop in the Basketball Champions League. And also the most unassisted points. That's 91 unassisted points, 88 points at the hoop or in the paint. But when we say in the paint, he's getting right to the hoop. When he starts going downhill, defenses have got a real problem, and AIK will know all about that. AIK are the Basketball Champions League champions from 2017-2018, and there's Howard St. Ruse and Igor Miletic getting his troops primed. Former Anvil player for 6 years, Anvil Wrocław player. Now AIK will be introduced. We've had a Basketball Champions League break, and in the break, AIK have beaten Lavrio and Prometheus. And they're currently fifth, so excuse me, fourth at 5-4 in the Greek League. In the most recent of those games against Prometheus, 73-68 win. Langford, 20 points, 3 rebounds, 3 assists. Howard St. Ruse, 14 points, 3 rebounds, 1 assist and 3 steals. Not only is he efficient, he is scoring well, he is assisting well, he is a great defensive player. So look out for him. He's got great length, big hands, and look out for him to anticipate, get steals, deflections. And now Anvil Wrocław. Last year in the Basketball Champions League, 4-10 in a regular season. Didn't get out to the playoffs. They want to change things around this season. There's their captain, Szymon Szewczyk. Such an inspirational player when he's on the floor and off it as well. They've won their game in the Basketball Champions League break, beating MKSDG 112-86. Mikhail Sokolowski, 28 points, 18 points, 6 rebounds, 4 assists, 2 steals, 4 of 6 from 3. And Ricky Lido, 5 of 9 from 3 for 17 points, 6 assists. But their key performers, of course, Roten, number 1 points per game and efficiency for this team. It's got the most points in the paint, as I say, 88 and unassisted, 91. Sean Jones is their number one rebounder. And Ricky Lido is their number one in assists. Also look out for Frimanis, Roland Frimanis as well. There's the two coaches, Igor Milicic and Ilias Papatheodorou, of course, formerly of Ike's great rivals, Pauk. And look at the crowd here at the Halamistro. Extraordinary scenes. Can hardly hear myself speak. Both teams know this is massive. We're at halfway after this game, halfway in the regular season. It's just massive. There's Ilias Papatheodorou. It's Papatheodorou. Pauk 2017 to 2019, Greece youth teams as well, has joined Ike this season. And Igor Milicic, former player here at Amwell Vojvodina, Croatian senior national team, and in 1994, under 18 championships, European silver, as Sokolowski throws it down in the warm-up. Massive game for him domestically recently. Here are the referees, Marius Kulin, Antonis Onkrodžas, Vilius Maculaitis, Romania, Latvia. Top officials on a big night in Poland. Last season's Polish League champions. They've won the last two Polish leagues at Wolfsburg. Here's the Ike starting five. Mario Chalmers, who they've picked up. Former NBA champion Keith Langford. Kalamakakis, Giannopoulos, and Stefan Jankovic. Moving players around Ike in the break, bringing in experience. There is Ilias Papatheodorou. He's used to this sort of noise, playing the OAKA in Athens, 18,000 capacity there. Big games require big players, and we've got two of the biggest scorers in the Basketball Champions League. There's Ricky Lido, former NBA star, and over to Amor Volchevek's starting five. Lido, Tony Roten, Ronans Frimanis, Szymon Szewczyk, and Mikhail Sokolowski, Polish international, played at the Basketball World Cup, had a fantastic tournament, as did Poland, finishing in the top eight of that tournament. And Tony Roten, he is so key for this team. Igor Milicic, former player here, 43-year-old Croatian, been at Anvil Volcevic as head coach since 2015. He is guiding this team at 3-3, just outside the round of 16 playoff spots. If you finish fifth and sixth at the end of the regular season, which will be in February, you go into the FIBA Europe Cup. Another great FIBA tournament, seventh and eighth, as we look at Mačiulis, Lithuanian sensation, and still a top international player. And what a great pickup for Ike. Now, for the good things that Anvil Volcevic do, one thing they've got to improve on is they've conceded more three-pointers, 73, than any other team in the Basketball Champions League this season. They've also conceded more points per game, second-chance situations. They've got to box out. They've got to stop the likes of St. Ruse getting to the hoop. Everybody's got to contribute. Piatek which in English means Friday. Well, tonight's Wednesday. Can it be, man, Friday's night when he gets on the floor? And there's Mario Chalmers, NBA champion with Miami. And now he finds himself here in a hotbed of Polish basketball. It's Anvil Volchevec versus Ike from Athens. This is one serious matchup. Two giants of their respective domestic countries, their domestic leagues. Who is going to come out on top? The last game day six. Anvil Volchevec won a thriller in Bandırma, Turkey by one. And Ike lost to Rasta Vector at home. They're going to be wanting to put that wrong to right tonight. Both teams have won in their domestic leagues since the break, since game day six. It's game day seven. And it's Kaklamanakis versus Szymon Szewczek. We're underway here in Poland. Ike get the first possession. Ike in black and yellow. Then Volchevec in white. First shot's up and good. Keith Langford has won it all in Europe. EuroLeague, EuroCup, former NBA player. Chalmers trying to get over the screen there. Great save. Threes up and long for Szewczek, but great job keeping it alive by Anvil Volchevec. Deep three, miles out. Again, Sokolowski is everywhere, and the crowd are loving that effort. Big game by him at the weekend in the Polish National League, PLK. And the horns and the trumpets at the Hala Mistral ring out here in Volchevec. Jankovic. Inside, outside. Langford for three is good. You can't leave him open. Great inside-outside movement by Ike. Tony Roten hasn't been able to get going yet. Just simple. Oh, that's beautiful. Fantastic play. Dragged all the Ike defense up, and Sokolowski just went back cut. Roten with the assist. Langford. Kaklamanis inside. Great pass to the weak side. No good. Big rebound. Blocked at the rim by Frimanis. And the play at the moment matching the atmosphere in the Hala Mistral in Volchevec, Poland. Kaklamanakis locked at the rim. Roten, they really keying on him. There was three players around him, no way through there. Chalmers with a nice pass, but no good. Tony Roten in transition with the throwdown. Just quick outlet. One dribble pushed ahead by Lado and thrown down. by the man of the moment in the Basketball Champions League in the conversation for the MVP. We've got at least three players on court. Here's one of them. Langford St. Rue's Anthony Roten playing great basketball so far in the Basketball Champions League. Inside, outside, shots up. No good for Langford, but they keep it alive, Dwight. Back to Chalmers. Just playing at a smooth pace. The former NBA champion pulls up for three. Long. Another rebound. We spoke early. Pre-game about Anvil Volchevec's problem with rebounding. It's already surfacing on the defensive end. And Shevchek. Zizmon Shevchek with the foul. He's coming out aggressively, as he often does, but he caught Chalmers in the chest. Inside, outside, extra pass by St. Rue's. All alone, Chalmers. Set shot style, but again, they can't get the rebound, Volchevec. Second chance efforts after second chance effort for Ike Athens. St. Rue's extra pass. Mario Chalmers, smart play. Really smart, and that was slightly soft defense there. He took the closeout. Shevchek's no match for Chalmers when he's attacking the basket like that. Tough move by Ricky Lado. He's no slouch either. St. Rue's, no good. Better rebound by Frimanis. Lado, Tony Roten on this side. He gets it. As the crowd scream, Anvil inside Frimanis. Tough angle though, no good. Here comes Langford. They're chasing him, but that leaves St. Rue's open. Turns down the shot. Ike have so many options and are a nightmare to defend when they spread the floor. And is that being possibly looked at as a continuation? There's hands on, hand checking there by Tony Roten. This game being played at breakneck speed. Shots up, is off by St. Rue's, and Anvil Volchevec gets the rebound. Roten, can he get free? Gets a foul. They are keying on him. They are helping off their players to smother any momentum. But Tony Roten, and that's what he wants to do. He can hit the three, but what he loves doing, and is shown in the stats so far, is get all the way to the hoop. Mario Chalmers' second foul, and he's only averaging about 1 point a game so far. Very little output in the two games he's played in the Basketball Champions League. Good pass, and good finish. Sean Jones there. Oh, good steal, Sokolowski. Steal, Sokolowski. Left hand finish, no good. But guess who? Tony Roten right there, right time. And Volchevec had their first lead of the game. Or first 3 point lead, excuse me. Shots up, not for long. 3-pointer from the corner, Jankovic. Serbian, Canadian, tied at 10, just under 4 remaining in the first. Good rebound, Sean Jones, leading rebounder, that's wide, and that's a great help. Ricky Lido with the slam, the crowd and myself included up on their feet on that play. Langford fouled by Sokolowski. These teams are going toe-to-toe, nose-to-nose. No one giving an inch. Great rebound, and look at Lado. Just throws it down one-handed. And Sokolowski's first foul. They won't be wanting to get him in any sort of foul trouble. Shots up. Short by Langford on the slight fade. He won't hesitate. Anvil Volchevic got to box out and get. And Lado nearly getting it stolen by Matulis, who was hurrying up behind him. Roten, Sokolowski. And Giannis Matulis. Matulis first foul. Incredible atmosphere here at the Halamistral. Absolutely rocking. Not a spare seat to be had. Wednesday night, Basketball Champions League action. Ricky Lido, Tony Roten. And he does throw the occasional crazy pass. You've got to watch out for that. Good steal. Here comes Volchevec. Good bounce pass. It almost was a good bounce pass. Maybe the pull-up for Lado. It was a good idea with Chase Simon ahead. But players backed off him. Maybe a pull-up would have been the best option. Penetrate, kick, nice look. And the three's good in the corner. Matulis, 2015 Lithuanian Player of the Year. A star throughout his career for Lithuania and Madrid. And great catch and finish. And another star, Sean Jones, former Jerusalem player. Great no-look pass by Tony Roten. And Jankovic, first foul. Volklevec by one. Sean Jones. Leading rebounder, 6.5 rebounds a game, and he knocks down the free throw for a three-point play and a two-point lead for Anvil Volchevec. The press is broken, a little bit of pressure comes into Matulis acting as the lighthouse there. St. Ruiz not needing the screen, hesitation, good pass, extra pass. Good pivot, but Matulis just couldn't see where he was, and as easy as you like, the ball falls into the hand of Hal St. Ruiz, the most efficient player on the Ike team, third in all of the BCL, the Basketball Champions League. Ricky Lido doesn't use the screen, but he didn't get completely open. Catch, shoot, it's good for Roland Freemanis. Kendrick Ray's in for Ike. Same position, but not quite for Matulis that time. Tony Roten, still Roten. In for Roten. That was tough. Had to shoot over his defender. He loves it. They love him here. And he is lighting up this game, and he's lighting up the Basketball Champions League. Yet again, another score in the paint, going to the hoop. And Howard St. Ruiz is one of the best defenders, an elite level defender, and he can't deal with him. One of the issues for defenders, Roten can finish either hand off either foot. Any way you want. come on, he's saying. It's Basketball Champions League night on livebasketball.tv. Looking at some of the stats going through, just wanted to listen to coach. He is not happy. Howard St. Bruce will take that upon himself to improve next time down the floor defensively. He did well not to foul Roten, but Tony Roten's got such great confidence and body control at the moment that he's tough to stop, and he's setting up his teammates as well. It's a real challenge for Ike. They lost their last game in the Basketball Champions League. They won't want to lose two in a row. And Anvil Bolshevik have never won three in a row at home, where they're on a two-game winning streak at the moment at home. Bachulis, nothing going. They're going to have to get the shot up. They do. And they're just long. And better rebounding. No second chance. Good job. And an attempted throw down by Frimanis. No good. That would have been dramatic if that had gone down. Machulis off balance, misses, offensive rebound, up. This is a wacky kind of game. It's crazy, crazy pace we're playing at. But Anvil Bolshevik somehow get the defensive rebound. And Chris Dow can bring it up. And Ricky Lido. Ricky Lader, 43rd pick of the Milwaukee Bucks. Former G League player, and Kendrick Ray picks up the foul. Here's Ricky Lader, and he is a really top, tough player for this Anvil Bolshevik team. Ricky Lader, 85% from the line. He's made 17 of 20 so far this season. 18 of 21 now, 19 of 22, and that's really good going as he heads off for a well-earned break. 8.4 seconds remaining in the first. Don't take your eyes off this one, folks. St. Ruse, deep three, is good. What a way to finish the quarter. Howard St. Ruse, number three in efficiency in the Basketball Champions League, knocks down a big three. At the end of the first, Anvil Bolshevik 22, Ike 18. And some of the game statistics, Bolshevik 67% from two, 25% from three, 100% from the line. Ike haven't been to the free throw line yet. They will want to change that. Let's listen in, Coach Milicic, and enjoy some of the highlights. Nice touch by Anvil Bolshevik's PA and music department, playing some Greek, traditional Greek music. Everyone enjoying it. What a night it is here. Extraordinary scenes. Fantastic atmosphere and some great play. And Tony Roten, Howard St. Bruce, Keith Langford, Ricky Lido, just top, top players. Mikhail Sokolowski, of course, not to forget him. Sean Jones as well, doing a nice job there, finishing with his left hand. So important when you're under close attention to finish with your left hand. And then Freemanis knocking down the three. Finish from the left, And that is two of the best players in the league going at it. And Tony Roten getting the score somehow. And this was how the first quarter came to an end. How would it finish any other way? The quality's been so good. Howard St. Rouge knocks down a big time deep three. Have you enjoyed the action on livebasketball.tv? Download the Basketball Champions League app. When you've got a moment, maybe at half time or the next time out, it's got everything you need for all the teams, all the players. And that's a great pass over the top, but good recovery. Chase Simon back outside. Shake and bake into the paint. And ball's loose. And Kendrick Ray just couldn't quite get to the loose ball. And Chris Dow is fouled. And he clearly got there first, and Kendrick Ray couldn't slow down. And that's Ray's second foul, and that's an issue for Ike Chalmers as well on two. So two of their guards, two of their playmakers in early foul trouble. Freemanis. And it's a travel. He had the three. Excuse me, that's Salima. Christoph Salima. He had the three-point shot. Didn't take it and then got called up in the air. St. Rouge to Matulis, back to St. Rouge. Just playing with such confidence and poise is Howard St. Rouge. That pass wasn't on though. That's brilliant by Roten and blocked. Salima just got called up there. And Chrissy Kopoulos coming back. Good job by Kendrick Ray, slowing down Salima, giving Chrissy Kopoulos time to get back and make the block. St. Rouge takes a break. And Langford back in. And the noise gets louder and louder here in Bolshevik. Salima. Baseline turnaround. And there is a foul on Nikos Gikas, former Prometheus player. And Chris Dow just backing the smaller Gikas down. And now Gikas, the next guard up on the Ike roster, is in foul trouble. Langford can handle the ball, but he's really your two guard, your shooter, your creator. Gikas will try and steady the ship for Ike. They trail by five. Handoff attack from the wing. It's Matulis, but blocked in midair. Here comes Sokolowski, no good. Gikas, big rebound, and he's streaking down the floor, still going, but the wraparound pass, no good. He may have had the chance of the pass slightly earlier in that play. Sean Jones with a wry smile, and that is a foul there by, potentially a foul. It was contact by Salima, and the foul has been given by Jones. Gikas slaughters in the game for Ike. Langford, Gikas attacks, pulls up off the glass, no good. Freemanis with the rebound. Sean Jones. And good defense for Mike, and they get the steal. Chrysikopoulos gets the ball to Gikas, high screen. Sokolowski comes out and recovers. Gikas, and there was a double team as he passed in midair. Sokolowski, and a foul with a quick pass ahead. Chris Dow fouled by Gikas, and now Gikas on two. Good transition defense by Gikas, but now he's on two fouls, and decisions need to be made by Coach Papathiodorou. Chris Dow, 28-year-old American, former from Paulo Lacoltez. Ironi Zeslion of Israel last season. And he knocks down that free throw to increase Volchevec's lead to six. And a foul called, and Gikas just having a tough night. And he's using his left arm to hook. And he's just made contact with the ref, and he's got to be careful. Mario Chalmers having to come back in. He's on two fouls. Volchevec doing everything they can to make it tough for their Greek visitors tonight. Sean Jones hands off for Imanis. Just got to keep the ball moving. And whistle away from the ball. Foul on Chris Dow there. Chalmers will be happy that he's not called on him, otherwise that would have been his third. Matsoulis attacking. Oh, he's blocked. Massive block by Sean Jones up the other end. Just long on the three, but Sokolowski gets the rebound. Shots up, no good. Chase Simon, offensive rebound is good. Chris Dow and Volchevec are playing with massive energy and high tempo, and Ike are struggling to stay with them at the moment. Mario Chalmers pulls up from the free throw line, no good. Freemanis with the rebound. 19 rebounds to 12 in favour of the home team. Sean Jones, no back cut on, but he gets it back to Freemanis. Off the glass! The bank is open in Volchevec. If you're Roland's Freemanis, it's timeout. Everything's going Anvil Volchevec's way, and that is a tough three-pointer. Doesn't matter, off the glass, and it's good. Timeout, Ike. Roman Freeman is averaging 11.8 7 points a game, 3.8 rebounds. He's up to 6 points already with that big three, and that's a massive block by Sean Jones. Not in this house. Former Jerusalem player, high level performer and rebounder, and has shown already he can block shots and score inside. So everything going Bolshevik's way, they've got to make the most of it. They lead by 11. Nearly halfway through the second. Sokolowski with another steal, bounce pass, Jones, left hand finish. I think that's goaltending. And they are playing for each other, with each other. Total team effort by Anvil Bolshevik. And it's proving too much for Ike at the moment. Step through by Jankovic, and he's fouled as he attempts to shot off the glass. Stefan Jankovic has played the two games in the Basketball Champions League. He's made his two free throws. Formerly with Partizan Belgrade. Now trying to help Ike, and they need him. They need everyone together, especially now that Tony Roten is back on the floor. Going against Chalmers, and good defense by Mario Chalmers. And he will be taking this as a good help across by Slaughter. Tony Roten's just got to pick his moments. Chalmers stayed with him. Brave defences, especially as he's on two fouls. Langford, ball's loose. And what are they going to call? Offensive foul against the league's leading scorer. He's really frustrated there at half court. And Ike are on the verge of boiling over here. He's trying to do it himself. Could have been a reach there from Sokolowski. Got an elbow in the mouth or something. Great defense. And they're potentially going to have a look at this. Sokolowski did reach. And he came into Langford's space. And that's maybe why he got the elbow in the mouth. Or are they going to look to see if this was over excessive from Langford? That's, I don't think he threw an elbow, it might just be, let's have a look, might have been a natural motion. And just a regular foul and possession to Bolshevik, but now that's Langford's first foul. They're into team fouls with 4:46 and counting remaining in the second. So Bolshevik will be well served. An offensive foul to just attack the paint at every opportunity. Put pressure on the Ike defense. Let's have a look what happened here. Jones. He's got his arms out in front. Offensive foul called on that screen. Oh, nice play. Slaughter getting caught up in midair. Nice pass in by Giannopoulos. But Marcus Slaughter got spun round, and when he was trying to shoot the ball, he was facing away from the hoop. He just oversteps and then spins round. Good defense by Primanis, and he just couldn't right himself in midair. Slaughter comes out. Coach Papathiodorou just trying to find the right chemistry. Can it be Mavridis? Greek international, such experience. as he steps out on Tony Roten, forces him to give the ball up. And he closes out too strongly on Freemanis. The Latvian wants... The Latvian wants the M1. I think that was... Well, he's on his way to the hoop. Could have been continuation. But it's team fouls anyway. So Freemanis will go to the line for two shots, not an and one. Previously played for Vefriga. Of course, they're in the Basketball Champions League. And he's played for the senior national team as well, has Freemanis. Doing a great job for his team as bodies fly. And Mario Chalmers, he is in the heat of a battle here with Tony Roten. And a cross came from Freemanis, and he just needed to get one step across. So his foot was on the baseline, potentially would have got a charge there and got Mario Chalmers up to three fouls, but it didn't quite happen. But the crowd appreciating Roland Freemanis' efforts. Chase Simon back in. Chase Simon, former Israeli All-Star with Maccabi Ashdod. Mario Chalmers. His first three throws of the competition. Didn't play in the last domestic game, did Chalmers? But look at this. Ball's up. And here goes Langford. He misses the layup. But great job on the offensive rebound by Jankovic. It's almost like Langford was expecting contact, went too far past the basket. Shevchek caught up with Jankovic. Both teams in team fouls. Shevchek's first foul. And it's timeout here. In Volchevik, Poland, it's Anvil Polchevik, timeout.
Let's try to force that to penetration, but not in three phase. Like earlier, one, you, yeah, when you penetrate, try to find extra pass. Now, you have height advantage. We go like this. 24, open up from here. Simon, get a good screen on Tony, dribble both here.
Anvil Volchevik leading by 8. As Demetrius Mavroidis plenty for his thoughts at the moment. It's just been really tough for Ike to get a foothold in this game, to get the right chemistry on the floor. Coach Papa Theodoro has been very frustrated. Stefan Jankovic makes the and one play. 11 points at the weekend versus Prometheus for Jankovic. And I think that if that's on Chalmers. I think that was away from the ball. Sokolowski at the line. Sokolowski, former Rosa Radom player in the Basketball Champions League. Polish senior national team in the Basket World Cup and Eurobasket 2017. Good ball movement from Ike. But they just can't get it to go. Great rebound, Shevchek. Sokolowski pushes ahead. Tack the closeout back to Sokolowski. Wide open for three. Wonderful team play. Simon attacks back to Sokolowski. Bounce pass round the corner. Nothing but string. And Jankovic, I think a foul called on the screen as we came back to play. It's physical, but the refs are calling it so tight on the screens. Let's have a look. He's moving as Roten's trying to get round the screen. He's moving with him. Once you set the screen, you've got to be happy what you've set and stay still. And that should be enough if the angle's right on the screen to get your teammate free. Ricky Lado, wide open three is just long from Shevchek. An offensive foul, I think, on Sokolowski. Fighting with Maciulis for position. He's playing with such intent tonight, Mikhail Sokolowski. He's got good inside position. I think that's a tough call if Maciulis doesn't go to the floor. Maciulis doesn't go to the floor. I don't think that's an offensive foul right there. Both teams in team fouls, so Maciulis to the line. Makes the first. What can we say about Maciulis? Lithuanian player of the year 2015. EuroLeague champion, Spanish league champion, Greek league champion. He's been a winner wherever he's gone, and Italian league champion back in 2012. And much success with the national team. But someone who's been having a lot of success, Tony Roten, but can't get that to go. Ike, can they start making inroads into this lead? Anvil Volchevic, it's all Langford. Wide open shot is good. Chalmers for three. Can that get Mario Chalmers going? 7 points for Chalmers. Roten, left hand, three, misses everything. Not a well-advised shot, and Ike get the defensive rebound. Chalmers, nice pass. Mavridis could have turned the other way, and he was open. Maciulis, ball's knocked loose. Mavridis has just drop-stepped over his left shoulder. He would have had an open shot there with his right hand. Langford against Tony Roten. Shots up, it's just off. And good outlet, great outlet. And the throwdown, what an outlet. And what a finish by Ricky Lado. That's wonderful from Chase Simon. Ike cannot get back. All they can see is Ricky Lado in midair throwing it down. He's up to 8 points. Superb action here in Poland. Shots up. It's good for three, Giannopoulos. Maciulis with the assist. Giannopoulos with the three. Under a minute remaining in the second quarter. Tacking the closeout, and they miss the layup. 4 point lead, Anvil Volchevic. Cross court, shots up again. It's good for three again. Kadis Giannopoulos. And just like that, Ike are right back in this. Nothing but string, his second three. First from the top, this time from the wing. Timeout, Anvil Bolshevik. Said in pre-game that Anvil Bolshevik have conceded more 373 than any other team, and second chance points as well. And they started to rectify that, rebounding much better on the defensive end. But Karis Giannopoulos has just highlighted the threes that are being conceded by Anvil Bolshevik. Roland's Freemanes. 7 points, five rebounds. But Ike have dragged themselves back with the foul trouble they've had, with the issues they've had, the frustrations they've had, the great play of Anvil Bolshevik really pushing them all the way in this first half. They just are down by 1 point. Chris Dow's going to inbound. Anvil Bolshevik, and the crowd are loving this entertainment. They're now going to have to see a determined end by Anvil Bolshevik. Roten all the way to the bucket, going downhill at pace with a right-hand layup. And Ike can have the last shot of the first half. Howard St. Ruse has had a quiet night so far. He did make a three at the end of the first. Langford, still Langford, wide open for Chalmers. He misses it off left, and that brings to an end a pulsating, breathtaking first half. It's halftime, Anvil Bolshevik 39, Ike 36. Igor Milicic just takes a moment to think about what he's going to say to the team as we look at the game stats. Twos, threes and free throws. Bolshevik, three more rebounds. 14 and 8. 12 assists to 7. Good job on the assists. 5 steals to 3. Both in favour of Anvil Bolshevik. And Igor Milicic looks shattered at half-time. Just head down. I'm sure he's not the former Anvil Bolshevik player. Top scorers, Lido 8, Roten 8, Jones 7, Jankovic 8, Chalmers 7, and Giannopoulos with the two threes to really drag Ike back into this game with 6 points. Well, it's set up perfectly for us here. Basketball Champions League, game day 7, live and exclusive on livebasketball.tv. As we see some of the highlights, which I'll leave you with, followed by the top 10 plays. The current top 10 plays at the moment, you'll enjoy those. And I'll rejoin you after that. Don't forget, download the Basketball Champions League app for all the information you could possibly require about this season's Basketball Champions League and previous seasons as well. If you click on the previous years, go into the About section. But it's all about Anvil Bolshevik as we see the bank three by Roland Freemanis. I'll leave you for a few minutes. Enjoy the halftime break. I'll see you shortly.
looks for another backdoor to Foster. Oh, baby! You gotta be kidding me! What a play by Marcus Foster! What a pass by TJ Klein! Oh, my Lord!
Now Young, over to Rachel. And Vasturia picks it up, hands it off, and great play from Vasturia. And hands it off to Murphy, who not only scores, but is fouled on the play.
That is.
Drives in, gets to Zasima, and Silla just with one of the blocks of the night. Boy, that was big time.
Kissick with the one-handed running slam.
It was that crossover movement that lost Galdikas, and he explodes to the basket. He's up to 22 points, another 20-plus point game for him.
Broughton has it on the ball reversal. He doesn't stop it. Oh! Get out of that highlight picture. Tony rolled down the middle. As we said, if you don't stop him, and he just threw it on.
Oh, what a play, the alley-oop to Brown. That was one of the plays of the game right there.
Tenerife need to execute. And now Hertas kicks it back out. Wide open three is good for Lundberg yet again. Nothing but net. And he loves it. Tenerife love it. Heartbreak for Befriga.
Gilovac's now a chance for Gaziantep if they rush. Boy, that was almost a foul on Komolov.
Rolfer goes up for the dunk out of nothing. Goodness gracious.
Jagela
goes inside with the big thunder drum.
And Jagela takes no prisoners with that play over the top of two Besiktas defenders. Jim Olasoy gets it to Crawford. Over to Saunders. He puts it up. He had a lot of time left.
Oh, he hit the three! Can you believe it? Unbelievable! There will be no overtime. 3 points shy by Saunders.
Welcome back to Wokalek in Poland. As Tony wrote, and so far, only just the 8 points. He's averaging just under 20 points a game. He has shown some big moments tonight, but they, Ike, have done a good job on him a lot of the time as well. They're just trying to contain him and to help at the right time, make things as difficult as possible for him so he can't get to the basket. He's the leader in points scored that are unassisted and also points scored in the paint, and that's right at the hoop, which is where he likes to get to, and he has got to tonight at times. Here's the Ike top scorers: Jankovic 8, Chalmers 7, and Giannopoulos 6 points. There's two big threes towards the end of the second quarter. So half time would have been some big things said by Ilias Papathiodoro. They've got to play with more energy. Transition defense. There's been a couple of plays where Anvil Volchevac have just thrown the ball right over the top of the retreating Ike defense for easy layups. Ike will need to do that. But as I say, they've got to trust each other. Giannopoulos, the Greek Datomi, as they call him, really, really came up big there for him. With two massive threes. And there's Stefan Jankovic, 8 points. 1 of 1 from three, 2 of 3 from the field. Former Partizan and Spezza, Savina Spezza player. Former Serbian league champion and went to college at Missouri and Hawaii. Played in the G League as well. So top talent, as of course Mario Chalmers, who was in the NBA with Miami, where he won the NBA title before joining Bologna, and now finding his way to Ike in Athens. So Anvil Volchevac have got it all to do again. They were leading by 11 as the Greek flag is in the house in Volchevac, Poland. Now they've got to push on again. Have Ike got a foothold in this game, and can they stay with the pace? And the direction and the direct play of Anvil Volchevac, the home team. Anvil Volchevac 3 of 3 and 3 coming into this game. Ike 4 and 2, and there's Mikhail Sokolowski again. Solid all-round game by the Polish international. 5 points, 2 rebounds, 2 assists, 4 steals. So there's big players, as I said pre-game. Sean Jones doing a really good job for his team. But you've got 2 of the 3 top scorers in the Basketball Champions League up to tonight, up in this game, with Langford and Tony Roten, and with Howard Saint-Ruiz being one of the most efficient players. But he's had a quiet night as well, Saint-Ruiz. He'd be wanting to really make his mark. Just 5 points, no steals. He's normally right up there with the steals as we get the third quarter underway. Chalmers gets it knocked loose by Tony Roten. They've not been very far apart from each other throughout the whole of this game. Shots up for three. It's good again. Giannopoulos. That's his third three. They've got to get out. Nice screen there. They've gone back to the hot hand. Have Ike, and they've tied the game at 39. Sokolowski was open, but he just couldn't keep hold of the pass. Ike can take the lead for the first time. Chalmers into the corner. Same again, same result. Kadis Giannopoulos with his full three of the night. Beautiful pass by Mario Chalmers into the corner. Nothing but net yet again. He's on fire, up to 12 points, 100% from three, and good defense from Ike as Tony Roten was forcing his way to the basket. Oh, Chulis, Mavridis and Chalmers surrounding the Volchevec star. That is the only way to stop him. And here goes to the line for two shots. Sroten's first free throws of the night. This is the second too. Just 46.7% from the line, Tony Roten. And Egon Milicic has now got to get his team backfiring. Amazing crowd here. Roten misses again. That's something he's really got to work on. Just 46% from the line now. Volchevec, Ica 100%. Mavridis in the post. Chalmers, ball's loose, and they get the steal. Push ahead, Sokolowski, no good. And no foul. Chalmers just over-dribbling slightly there. They got away with it, Ike. Chalmers. And Sokolowski called for a foul as he stepped out, trying to get the steal. He did get ball first, but he got a lot of Machulis as well. Giannopoulos, they won't let him shoot the three. Mavridis all the way across, other side. Machulis is going to try. No good. And Kalis Giannopoulos, hands up. Offensive foul on the attempted rebound there. Giannopoulos just averaging 3.8 points a game, and he's up to 12. Having a great shooting night from behind the arc. And Roman Frudanis just can't get the shot to go as he attacked the basket. Langford, leading scorer in the Basketball Champions League. And that's exactly why. Spin dribble all the way to the hoop. Tony Roten, third in scoring in the whole league. Ricky Lado, step back three, is just off. And rebound, Mavridis. Doing a job for his team. Langford dancing outside the three-point line to Chalmers. Nice pocket bounce pass, but no good from Machulis. He just couldn't get the finish. Tough pass, and Sean Jones is fouled in traffic. Chalmers there, Machulis and Mavridis coming over and committing the foul. Sean Jones at Hapoel Holon last season in the Basketball Champions League, and Dinamo Sassari before that, so good Basketball Champions League experience. Avellino as well, and Hapoel Jerusalem. And he's having a big game tonight, just when required. 7 points, 8 points, four rebounds, three assists. Langford, the noise is deafening here at the Hala Mistral. Mavridis, he's got that shot if he wants it, but he's not taking it. Machulis with a nice up fake, gets fouled, and he'll go to the line for two shots. Machulis, 81.8% from the line, averaging 8.2 points a game on the season. And he's just about to reach that mark if he knocks down the free throw, which he does. So another efficient night from the Lithuanian all-star. That's a tough move by Roten, and Ike get the rebound. Chalmers on the run. Inside, Mavridis step through, just can't get it to go, and Sokolowski gets the rebound and he's fouled. Giannopoulos with the foul as Sokolowski was streaking up the floor after getting the defensive rebound. Mavridis, that's a tough miss. Maybe annoyed with himself for not making that so close to the hoop. Sokolowski gets away and they're just looking to see if it's a regular foul or intentional, and it's a regular or unsportsmanlike. Giannopoulos judged to have committed that foul. It's a 6-point lead for Ike, having been down by as many as 11 points in the first half. Ricky Lino attacks, and there's a foul on the floor. This certainly is an inspirational place to play, the Hallamistro. Absolutely packed here on a Wednesday night in the Basketball Champions League. Giannopoulos heads for the bench. Howard St. Bruce is in. Just the 5 points, one rebound, one assist. No steals tonight. And Licky Lino gets the score. He's up to 10 points, four rebounds, three assists. Big night for him. 4-point lead for Ike. Great catch and throw down by Jonas Mačiulis, and the defense just didn't react. Nice pass over the top and straight down the middle for Jonas Mačiulis. 6-point lead for Ike. Ricky Lino catch, shoot for three, and the crowd erupts and get off their seats. Just simple pass from Tony Roten, but so effective. Lino up to 13 points. 4 of 9 from the field. Still almost deflection by Sokolowski. Gets in the passing lanes. He's totally committed to the calls, whether he's playing for his club or his beloved country, Poland. Chalmers inside to St. Ruse. Langford, Chalmers, St. Ruse. Step back three is off by Chalmers. And defensive rebound, almost stolen. We said he hadn't got a steal. He nearly had one there, St. Ruse. Deflects it out of bounds. That was a dangerous outlet with Ike players staying up. Halfway through the third. Hope you're enjoying this amazing game in the Basketball Champions League. Tony Roten against Howard St. Ruse. Roten for three is way off. That's a crazy shot. And there's a foul on Sokolowski, and but they were put in trouble really by, and that's his fourth foul, that's massive for Sokolowski. They were put in trouble by Tony Roten's quick fire three that ended up as a long rebound, and Langford was going to the hoop there, he got fouled. Keith Langford, VTB United League Hall of Fame. Played for Maccabi Tel Aviv, Azure League top scorer and Eurocup top scorer. Top player. And now he's gracing the Basketball Champions League. Shots up and good for three. Romans Frimanis, he's playing big. It's a massive game halfway through the regular season. And Romans Frimanis stepping up to the plate. And they're stepping out on the screen and roll. But Matulis, calm as you like, spins one way, pivots back to his right hand for a short-range jump hook. Ike by four. Ricky Lido off the glass, no good. Offensive rebound, kept alive for three. Just off by Frimanis. Same spot, not quite the same result. They're doubling up. Howard Semeru's extra pass. Just short, but good deep offensive rebound by Mavridis. Back to Mavridis. Cross to Chalmers. Screen inside as he dives to the bucket. But if he'd gone left, he was open for a short-range shot. Ricky Lido. Three off the dribble is good. Outrageous three by Ricky Lido. And he is having one heck of a game. And a collision at midcourt as well. As we come back to the live action and Chalmers is down. Chris Dow is down. Ricky Lido, 16 points, 6 rebounds, 4 assists, 3 steals. He is doing it all, especially with Tony Roten, only with 8 points, 3 rebounds and 3 assists. We're under 3 minutes remaining in the third. Howard Semeru's, no way through there. Langford for 3, just long. Offensive rebound by Howard Semeru's. And he will go to the line for 2 shots as Anvil Bolshevik go into team fouls. Semeru's, former Chez Nimberg in the Champions League, where he won the Czech League twice. And FIBA Intercontinental, champion, of course, with Ike. And the Greek League's best defensive player. Hasn't shown much of that tonight, but plenty of time for him to show his defensive prowess. 2-point lead for Ike. Kick back out, 3 minutes for a deep three. That was contested as well, and Slaughter hits the deck. That wasn't a great offense by Bolshevik. Semeru's to Chalmers. Chalmers, excuse me. Kendrick Ray misses everything. Lido hesitates. And he's fouled. Left hand nearly went. He's really feeling it. Tony Roten having a quiet night so far. Ricky Lido picking up the slack. And Semeru's was there and he went hard into that Ike defense. Ricky Lido, 17 points in the last game. 4 rebounds, 6 assists. in the latest domestic game against MKSDG. Sokolowski, 28 minutes, 18 points, 6 rebounds, but he's off the court in foul trouble. Lido leading the way. And Volchevec down by one. Hope you're enjoying the action on livebasketball.tv. Basketball Champions League. Howard St. Ruse almost deflected by Lido there. Shot clock running down. Langford back to Howard St. Ruse. Deep three is off. And defensive rebound. Ricky Lido is doing everything and he has lost it. First steal of the night for St. Ruse. And he lays it in. You can't keep a good man down. And just when Anvil Volchevec was starting to turn the tables, Ike and Howard St. Ruse pounce for a steal and a layup. Almost another steal. Lido dribbles out, goes right, attacks the basket, and is fouled. Marcus Slaughter coming over to help. Marcus Slaughter just turned in midair, and that was a foul. Both teams in team fouls as we enter the final minute of the third. It's been played at breakneck pace. An enthralling encounter. As Langford takes a seat. Leading scorer in the Basketball Champions League up to tonight. Chris Wright is tucked in just behind him after his 31-point effort last night in the double overtime loss to Philly Ostender. Sokolowski comes back in. Lido takes a break. Now this is massive minutes. Will Ike go straight at Sokolowski, try and get him fouled out? He's got to play really smart. Good defense, Chase Simon. Simon hands it off and they can't get the finish. But look who's there. He's playing like a man inspired. Playing for the Cools. Rolands Freemanis. Offensive rebound. It's just out of control there, but Marcus Slaughter didn't box out. He got pushed under the hoop. Now Freemanis will go to the line for two shots, and Chalmers up to three fouls. Freemanis, he had 15 points at the weekend as well. So him and Lido, Sokolowski carrying on their good play from their domestic league into the Basketball Champions League. Kendrick Ray and Chalmers on together. Machulis is good for three. Beautiful catch and shoot in the corner. Jonas Machulis. Ike by two. Back and forth we go. Momentum change, followed by momentum change. Chris Dow, 3 minutes. What can he do? That's a tough shot, and it doesn't make the hoop, and it ends the third quarter. That just wasn't his play. End of the third, and Will Volchevec 56, Ike 58. just enjoying the highlights of what has been a top game, and the crowd are so into this, really making it a wonderful spectacle. And of course the players, top players on show, just delivering time after time after time. Ricky Lido in particular is the latest to have really pushed his game to another limit. And Roland Frimanis, slight blip at the end of the third there, not quite getting his shot off as he would have liked. But Jonas Mačula is showing the full repertoire with the dunk, the good footwork and the jump hook, and the three in the corner there just really encapsulates what a top level player he is. And there's Ricky Lido, a couple of big time threes off the dribble. Mačula's up to 14 points. And that was the first steal of the game for Howard Semrouz. We'd said that he hadn't had a steal. He got a deflection off a outlet pass and then got the steal and the layup. And that's how he gets a lot of his plays and his highlight plays. And he's had plenty of them so far this season. So, fourth quarter is starting. It's a two-point lead for Ike. And they get it back. Frimanis with a push shot is good for two. He's showing his full array of shots, just as Jonas Mačula's is. 14 points for Frimanis. Howard Semrouz, oh, nice Eurostep. And then the reverse layup with his right hand from the left. Howard Semrouz starting to play at a high level. Šefček to Ricky Lido. They double up on Lido. Howard Semrouz, Kendrick Ray finishes with the left hand. And a quick start by Ike. 4-point lead for the visitors. 12 turnovers to 11. Ike with 12. Ricky Lido, fade away. Three is good. Big time shot from Ricky Lido. Chalmers to Howard Semrouz. Back to Chalmers. Shot clock running down. Chalmers is going to have to shoot the long two. That was all Chalmers, no ball movement, apart from the one pass to Howard Semrouz. High screen from Šefček. He can make this shot, and he just can't tonight, though. Hasn't made a three. Kendrick Ray. Ray, nice pass. Howard Semrouz on the back cut along the baseline, and he's starting to stamp his authority on the game. Steals, dunks and layups, and he's really imposing himself now. Šefček will try one more time, and it's good. This time for the Bolshevik captain and inspirational leader. Tied at 64. Wonderful pass from Chris Dow. Shots off by Jankovic. And now Bolshevik can take the lead. And the crowd get to their feet. But look who it is again. Semrouz throws it down with a trademark steal and slam. You can't lose your concentration when Howard Semrouz is anywhere near the basketball. If you're Anvil Bolshevik, and there was a prime example there. Knocked loose there by Kendrick Ray. Šefček misses the layup. Here comes Ike on the break, inside, outside. And defensive foul called on Chase Simon. And the pace of play up again. And that was tough call because Kendrick Ray's left elbow was out, stretched into the neck of Chase Simon. Now it's St. Bruce. Well, St. Bruce got airborne, but they retrieve it, or do they? Ball's loose, and Anvil Volchevec, great job. Players diving on the floor. Tony Roten in the game. Shots up. That was a tough fadeaway for Lado that time. They need better looks than that. And Tony Roten, if he can get to the hoop and cause some havoc in the Ike defence. Langford back in the game. Wide open shot is good for Stefan Jankovic. Simple but effective by Ike. 4-point lead, Ike, and beautiful backdoor cut, and alley-oop. Chase Simon gets the score. 17 assists for Volchevec. Beautiful pass and slam for Slaughter. You can't take your eye off this one. Inside, outside dribble, Kendrick Ray, and the wraparound pass for Slaughter to finish at the rim. Roten to Ricky Lido. Lot of attention. Someone will be open. Freemanis. What can he do? He can just drop it over the top. He had Slaughter on his hip. The help didn't come across quick enough. And Roland Freemanis finishes over the top. And a foul called on the floor. Roten committing the foul on Langford before he can get going to the hoop. Volchevec not in foul trouble. That's Roten's second foul, so no harm done there for the home side. Langford double teamed. St. Ruse. Slaughter guarded by Shevchek. Nice pass. Shot short. And the offensive rebound, no good. Three on two momentarily. Roten. Push shot is good by Chase Simon. And we are tied yet again here in Volchevec. Timeout, Ike Athens. The shot was missed, three on two. Nice pass by Tony Roten. Just don't know what he's going to do next. It was slightly behind Simon, but with Howard St. Ruse closing down on him, he was able to get the soft push, jump hook over the top with the outstretched hand of Howard St. Ruse. Let's listen in to Coach Papa Theodori. What a game. This Basketball Champions League is delivering at a higher level in its fourth season now. Tenerife, Ike, and Virtus Bologna are the three champions of the previous seasons. Who's going to be champion this year? 32 teams in the regular season. You've got to be in the top four to get through to the round of 16. And a steal, and they push. Tony Roten is good. Once they push the ball ahead, Tony Roten is unstoppable. Great outlet, one hand, and Roten attacks Keith Langford, and he's no match for him. Anvil Volchevec take the lead. Matulis against Freemanis. Matulis, tough fadeaway, no good. And this time, Ricky Lido with a one-handed rebound. And they slow down to get their breath, to give everybody a chance to get their breath in this pulsating, enthralling Basketball Champions League encounter. Roten, offensive foul wonderful defense, brave defense by Keith Langford, and Tony Roten appreciates that. He decided he was putting his head down, and Langford, clever play by the league's leading scorer, showing that he can get down and dirty on defense too. Howard St. Ruse in motion, but another steal. And ahead, but too far for Chase Simon as he gave chase in vain. Great effort though by both teams. They are on the limit, pushing themselves beyond their normal limits to try and get this game. It feels like a playoff game, thanks to the crowd and of course the stupendous play of both teams. Langford, shot fake, no good. And Roten, what's he gonna do? He just gets the foul off Matulis. Just slowed down enough that Matulis would reach across. Clever play by Tony Roten. And the crowd are loving this as we take a breath and Volcevec have a timeout. Let's listen in to Coach Milicic. Offensive instructions given out, but the last thing Coach Milicic said was play defense, and they're getting in the passing lanes, some ill-advised passes, but they are getting in the lanes, and the quick out that leads to this Tony Roten finish. Again, there's such good players on show, and Langford, Howard St. Rose, Tony Roten, Ricky Lido, other players stepping up for Imanis as well. Shevchek is there when required, as he steps out, 33, and Ricky Lado for three, is good! Unreal! What a game he's having, stepping up where Tony Roten offensive output is slightly down. Ricky Lido's loving it and enjoying himself right here, right now. Deep three for Ike, is off, offensive rebound. Fantastic effort by Matulis. Using all of his 1m98 there. He rebounds so well. He can do it all. Third foul for 3 minutes. Inbound, St. Ruse. Plenty of time remaining. 5-point lead as they just get the ball into Slaughter. Giannopoulos is in the game. Step back for Langford, is good! What a three! What a moment for the league's leading scorer. And it's a foul on Roten. As soon as the step back, Roten steps out and clearly fouls him on the arm. What concentration from Keith Langford. Extraordinary marksmanship. Full foul for Tony Roten. And a 4-point play turns things right around. 1-point lead for Volcevec. Langford just 12 points tonight. 5 assists, 3 rebounds. Roten, Tony Roten, shakes, bakes, left hand, finish is impeccable. And he points across at somebody and says, come on, let's go. Nice job by Langford in response. Turns the corner. No help there. He went early before Bolshevik could set the defence up. What a game. What a competition this is. The fourth edition of the Basketball Champions League. 1 point lead, Bolshevik. 1:40 remaining. Roten all the way across, but that's a wild pass. He is prone to the occasional questionable decision. Very rarely, I must add. 15 turnovers each, that's a good effort from both teams, but that was unforced to an extent. He had other options on. But if you pressure the ball, get your hands up, get your hands in the passing lanes, it puts pressure on the team with the ball and they can make errors or uncharacteristic errors. Now, Ike can take the lead. Langford, what's he going to do now? Freemanis steps out. He's got Chase Simon on him. And there is a whistle. And Langford is just doing it all now. Right-hand dribble, creating the contact. Not going at any breakneck speed, just waiting for Simon to come across and commit the foul. And it's timeout. No, it's not a timeout. It's Keith Langford at the line for two shots. And he's missed, didn't look comfortable on that one. Three of four tonight. That's his first miss from the line. Makes the second to tie the game. 86.6% excuse me, 87.5%. 14 of 16 they are as a team. Tied at 77, 1 minute 20 remaining in the fourth. Great action here. Basketball Champions League, Ricky Lido against Howard St. Ruse. He's on the floor. He gets helped out by Tony Roten. That's off, and a big rebound by Giannopoulos. Langford all the way to the bucket, but he misses. Unbelievable miss. Under a minute remaining. Ricky Lido uses the screen, wide open three. Too much. There's still time. Langford, so dangerous. Gets across the timeline. 3 minutes, tries to get the ball out of his hands. Who else can score? Ball is not loose. Ricky Lido asking for it to be reviewed. He thinks the ball's come off Slaughter. Let's see what they're going to do here. And Coach Papathiodorou is maybe asking them not to check if he thinks it was off Slaughter. Let's have a closer look from the baseline. One more look, Matulis attacks. Sean Jones balls up. And that, I think, is off Slaughter's hand. And Ricky Lido, of course, Ricky Lido points one way, Slaughter points the other. Let's have another look. The Matulis miss, and was it off Slaughter then? Fingertip off Ricky Lido, and they've kept the call the same way. How important is this going to be? Timeout called. Vojcevic have no fouls to give. And Vojcevic. So they will have to play straight up D, otherwise they'd be sending Ike to the free throw line. Let's listen in to Coach Papathiodorou.
Here is Jonas. You ask the ball, Lucas.
Well, watch drama here yet again. Double overtime game last night, which I covered in Belgium, which was unbelievable drama. And this matches it, and maybe we'll even surpass it. Will we need overtime to decide this encounter? Slaughter on the floor for Ike. Giannopoulos, game tied, they only need a two. Langford, plenty of time still on the shot clock. They double team, Ruse attacks, inside Mačiulis for the slam. What a pass and what a finish for Jonas Mačiulis. They kept scrambling the Bolshevik defense. In the end, somebody was going to be open. James came off Mačiulis to help. Perfectly timed pass for St. Bruce. And it's a two-point lead for Ike. Timeout, Anvil Volklovec. Coach Milicic got his instructions right in the end, but the coaches are under so much pressure. They have to deliver a clear timeout with clear instructions for such an important play. But Jonas Mačiulis, the Lithuanian legend and a winner wherever he has been in European basketball, makes a winning play potentially right there for Ike. 14 seconds. And for Volchevec to win the game with a three or tie with a two. They get it inbounded. Freemanis. Ricky Ledu. Of course, Ike have plenty of fouls to give. So that's a smart play and another timeout. They will foul before any shot goes up if they can. So Anvil Volchevec have really got to make good screens. And get somebody wide open so they can't get fouled before they shoot the ball. Here's Anvil Volchevec, timeout, let's listen in. Coach Milicic just said you have to shoot before they foul you, and that is a big time throwdown. By Jonas Mačiulis. He may be the other side of 30 years old in age, but he is playing like a young man. He's thinking like a young player, and he delivered like a star player right there. So away we go again. Quick foul. The only thing that could go against Ike is if they foul, and it's looked upon as being an intentional foul. But it's really good tactics by them. They have only had two fouls this quarter. Slaughter's in no foul trouble at all. 6.7 seconds. Are Anvil Volchevec going to get a good look? This is the issue. I'm not sure what Tony Roten was doing there. He's just thrown the ball up at half court. He wasn't being fouled. Players were free. And he's just thrown the ball up at half court, and that lady can't believe it, and I can't quite believe what he's done there. Timeout, Ike. Maybe Tony Roten felt the contact from Matulis and tried to get a shooting foul. But now Ike can inbound the ball in the front court. 2.7 seconds remaining, and Volcevic are going to have to foul straight away. They're in team fouls. And they will reset the clock. But Jonas Matulis has the opportunity with two made free throws to potentially put it beyond the plucky and courageous hosts here, Pavel Volcevic. He made the dunk to give them the 2-point lead off the St. Ruse assist. He's just missed the first. This game is not over. He misses. Now they've got to shoot the ball. And they want the foul on that shot to Danvil Volcevic. But I think the game is over. There's no foul called. Final score, Danvil Volcevic 77. Ike, run out winners, finally, 79. Extraordinary game, yet again. Both teams just delivered a high-level game, but Danvil Volcevic just couldn't get the look they wanted when they were two down after the Matulis dunk. And then Tony Roten threw the ball up from half court, and Ike were able to get the job done, even with Matulis missing both the free throws. So Ike go to 5-2 and are right at the top of this group. And Danvil Volcevic fall to 3-4, but they played so well. And this crowd have been amazing here tonight. I've hardly been able to hear myself think. They are going to be absolutely devastated at the moment, but they've got to hold their heads high as we look at the statistics. Just 61% from the line for Volcevic. 40 rebounds, 37, 19 to 17 assists. Coach Milicic looks crestfallen. Just couldn't get a good look on that play at the end. But you can see what it means to the team and the fans. Top scorers, Lido Frimanis Roten for Volcevic. Langford Matulis St. Ruse with a big three for Ike. But the captain of the team speaking with fans and players. And as we look at the highlights, it was just a pulsating and breathtaking encounter tonight. But Ike just did enough. Nice Euro step from St. Ruse. But Volcevic were leading by 11. Then Ike came all the way back earlier in the game to lead themselves. Then they pushed on ahead. Then Volcevic came back to lead. and it was back and forth. Just top plays by top players. I said this could be a classic. It's turned out to be. It was just unfortunate that Bolshevik couldn't get a good look to try and tie the game themselves. And Ike ran out winners off the Mathurlis dunk. And Howard St. Rouge just started in that second half to impose himself on the defensive end with that steal. And of course, another highlight dunk. And that was a nice steadying the ship shot by Jankovic. And then a throw down by Slaughter off the wraparound pass by Kendrick Ray. But just top play by teams at the top of their game. And Roland's three-man is the Latvian international. And here came Tony Roten with the pass and finish by Chase Simon. And they just thought that Amir Voltrevec were going to get it done, but then Ike came back right towards the end. And the crowd were just constant noise. And they made this such a special evening on Wednesday night of the Basketball Champions League. They urged their team on. Kendrick Ray off the dribble, splash. And that's one of the top defenders in this league, if not the best defender in the Basketball Champions League. And he's hit that right in his face. And then Langford with a four-point play. Top going into this game, the top scorer up against the third leading scorer in the whole league. Going head-to-head there, and Langford wins that one. And then tricky. Very tricky, Tony Roten. And then this was the final score of the game. Jonas Mathurlis off the Howard St. Maru's penetrate, dish, and flush by Jonas Mathurlis. Double team. Langford left his feet. Tony Roten just couldn't get the steal. And St. Maru's attacks the middle of the key. Now Sean Jones helped off Mathurlis, but he didn't help big enough, unfortunately. His hands weren't outstretched enough. But maybe if they were, St. Maru's would have delivered a bounce pass to St. Maru's instead of the chest pass. And disbelieving fans, but they've been treated to a classic here in Wojciech, Poland. Here's the Group B standings. Ike and Jerusalem at the top. And Anvil Wojciech in fifth. So close, but yet so far for them. Hope you've enjoyed this edition of the Basketball Champions League. Don't go anywhere. Livebasketball.tv have got more Basketball Champions League games this evening. My name's Graham Hiscott. I've really enjoyed bringing this game to you. Congratulations to Ike. They march on. Good night. Enjoy the rest of your evening.
Thank you.